हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू योर चैनल मैक फिजिक्स इज हियर बाय मयूर अग्रवाल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू टॉपिक फैक्टराइजेशन विद द हेल्प ऑफ कंसाइज मैथमेटिक्स क्लास 9th चैप्टर नंबर 5। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियोस आई हैव गिवन यू सो मेनी टॉपिक्स, सो आई होप सो इन दिस पैंडमिक पीरियड यू आर गोइंग थ्रू दीज दोज वीडियोज सो दैट यू कैन इंक्रीज द कॉन्फिडेंस ऑन योर टॉपिक्स। So without any let's start the today's topic. Today we have to solve factorization. What is factorization means? So first of all, I am telling you, factorization means a given expression, the expression which has to be given in the question, we have to convert that expression in the multiplication forms as much as we can solve it and write it in the multiply forms, in the product form. That is called as factorization. So factorization is a very wide chapter. There are so many methods consisting in this chapter. So one by one, step by step, we are proceeding. So in the first exercise, we have generally two methods. First method is directly taking common, and the second method, after making groups, or we can say grouping the terms, we can take common. So let's start exercise. Question number one is saying 2x minus 5y, 3x plus 4y minus 6, 2x minus 5y and x minus y. So if we observe this question, we find that there are two terms. First term is this, and second term is this completely, because we know very well the positive and negative sign separates the terms. So negative sign is lying here, so means this is the first term and this is the second term. Okay, so we have to search out some common things between these two terms. So if we talk about the numbers, the numeral over here is 2 and the numeral over here is 6. So what is the common between 2 and 6? We can take 2 as common. And this bracket 2x minus 5y is written here also and here also. So we can take 2x minus 5y also common. Now according to the question, only these two terms are common. So now we are using a big bracket. After taking common from the first complete term, 2 has been taken out, 2x has been taken out. So the remaining will be 3x plus 4y. This will be remaining from the first term. After that minus sign. Now, when we come to the next term, so 2 we have taken common and here the numeral is 6. So 3 will be remaining, 2x minus 5y we have taken common, so the resultant will be x minus y. So after taking common from the second term, we have the result 3x minus y. Now you have to just simplify it. 2x minus 5y, 3x plus 4y minus 3x plus 3y. So after that 2x minus 5y, after that 3x will be cancelled out, 4y and 7y, 3y, 7y. So 2 into 7y into 2x minus 5y. So at last you can multiply them. So the answer will be 14y and 2x minus 5y. So this will be the final answer. So in the answer we can see that we have no other terms. We have overall only a term, because you can see that there is no plus and minus sign between them. Yes, minus sign we can see here also, but it is inside the bracket. So that is why we can say that we got only one term. From the two terms given in the question, the result which we are forming, that consists only one term, which is proving that our answer is totally correct. So factorization means just to convert all the terms, two terms or three terms or four terms, how many terms are given in the question, we have to convert it in a single term. So this is the method. In this question, we have to just take directly common. In the numerals, we can take 2 as common, and according to the question in the brackets, 2x minus 5y is common. So let's come to the question number 2 now. So as we can see in the question number 2, the question is xy, 3x square minus 2y square. Okay, let me write in the separate way because it is a very lengthy question, so it is not easy to understand if I break it. Okay, so let me erase this question. Now I am going to write the question separately. The question number 2. It is saying that xy in brackets 3x square minus 2y square. After that minus yz in the bracket 2y square minus 3x square and plus zx 15x square minus 10y square. So in this question, we have to first change some terms because we can see very well in the first, there are three terms. First term is this, second term is this, and third term is this. Okay. So outside the bracket, if we talk about the outside the bracket, here xy is written, here yz is written, and here zx is written. So nothing is common. We have to search out a term which is common in all these three. So here xy, z is absent. Here yz, x is absent. And here zx, so y is absent. So none of the term is present in all the three constant which are written on the outside the bracket. So we cannot take anything common from these. Now we are talking about inside bracket. Here 3x square minus 2y square is written. And here the terms are same, but they are written oppositely. Means 2y square is negative, 3x square is positive in this part. But 3x square is negative and 2y square is positive. So we have to convert this. And in the last, 15x square minus 10y square, we have to take 5 as common. Okay? So before starting any step, we have to search out, is there anything common in the first step? So let's start. So first of all, first term remains same. In the second term, we are going to take minus s common. So when you take minus s common, it will become 3x square minus 2y square. After that, you can take 5 s common. So when you will take 5 s common, then the result will be 2x square minus 3y square. So this will be the remaining part. 15x square minus 10y square. So 15, 5, 3, the 3 will come here. 3x square minus 2y square. So now we can see that 3x square minus 2y square here also and here also. But also some changes we have to do. The first term will remain same. Now we can see that minus and minus, it will become plus now. Yz again, 3x square minus 2y square plus this 5 will come with zx. So 5zx again, 3x square minus 2y square. Now in all the three terms, we have one thing is common, that is 3x square minus 2y square. And the remaining terms, xy plus yz and plus 5zx. So this will be the final answer. Because nothing is possible after this step. So we can see that there are overall three terms separately. But in the answer, we have found only one term. So you can see that there is no positive and negative sign. Two brackets and between the brackets, there is a multiply sign. So this is the complete factorization of question number 2. So some questions have very different method. In this, we have to first make the brackets same, similar. Then only we can take that bracket common. So this is the question number 2. Now we are coming to question number 3. Question number 3 is saying AB, A square plus B square minus C square minus BC, C square minus A square minus B square. After that plus CA, A square plus B square minus C square. Now we have to look that in this bracket, A square plus B square minus A square is written clearly. In the last bracket, it is also same, but in the middle bracket, it is not same. So first, we have to make it proper. So what we can do, AB, A square plus B square minus C square. First term remains same, minus BC. After that, we are taking again minus common. So when you will take minus common, then A square will become positive, B square will become positive, and C square will become negative. And plus CA, last bracket will also be same. Now we have to change the sign over here. So AB, A square plus B square plus C square, negative and negative it will become positive. BC, A square plus B square minus C square, here minus sign is there, but sorry for that. Plus CA, A square plus B square minus C square. So we can see that now all the three brackets have same term. So we can take common a square plus b square minus c square. Now, the terms remaining ab from here plus bc and from here plus ca. So, that will be the final answer in this question. So, it is also the same. First, we have to make the bracket similar or same. Then we have to take that bracket common and then remaining terms will lie inside the another bracket. So, this is the question number 3. So, as I told you, for solving the factorization, wherever you have to take common, wherever you can take common, you have to take. Then only you can simplify the question and factorize completely. Now, we are coming to the question number 4. In question number 4, it is saying that 2x a minus b, 2x a minus b plus 3y 5a minus 5b and after that plus 4z 2b minus 2a. So as we can see in this question now, in the first bracket a minus b is given, in the second bracket 5a minus 5b is given. So we can have to take 5 as common because 5 is present in both the terms. Similarly, in the last bracket 2b minus 2a is written. So we have to do two steps in the last bracket. First thing, we have to take 2 common. And the second thing, because in the first term a minus b is forming, in the second term a minus b is forming, but in the third term b minus a will be formed. So we have to take minus as common. So before starting any step, first, we have to observe the question properly. Then we have to make the logics that what we have to do to say to make the bracket similar. Now, the first term will remain same, 2x a minus b plus 3y. Now, we have to take 5 as common, a minus b. Now, plus 4z, we have to take minus 2 as common, so a minus b. Now, simplify all the things, 2x a minus b plus 3y into 5a minus b, after that minus plus minus 4z into 2a minus b. Now you have to multiply all the terms, 2x a minus b plus 15y a minus b and minus 8z a minus b. Now you can take a minus b as common. So a minus b common, 2x plus 15y minus 8z. That will be the final answer of the solution. So, in this way, you can solve the question number 4. Now, without any delay, we are coming to question number 5. But, as we have seen, in the up to question number 4, we have to take just common. Either by directly taking common or we have to convert a little, then we have to take common. But, from question number 5, the methods will be changed a little. What changes will be there from question number 5? You have 4 or 6 terms given in the question, but you have to group together. Right now, all the terms are written clearly, but from question number 5, the terms may be written here and there. So, you have to make a group so that the brackets will remain same. First, you have to make group together the terms, then you have to make the brackets in there. So, look at question, how can we solve? Question number 5 is saying a cube plus a minus 3a square minus 3. 4 terms are written. So now we have to make these 2 terms as a group and these 2 terms as a group. So observe the carefully. When you take these 2 terms common, so a will be common between these 2 terms. So the remaining will be a square plus 1. So observe carefully. You have to take common between these 2 terms. So here a cube and here a. So you can take a as common. When you divide a cube by a, you know very well when you will take common means divide. So the result will be a square only. That is why I have written a square. And when you take a with a common, that is why 1. Between these 2 terms, minus 3 as common. So again the result will be a square plus 1. Now you can see that a square plus 1 here also, a square plus 1 here also. So, you can take a square plus 1 in first bracket and in second bracket the remaining terms a minus 3. So, this will be the solution of this question. So, you can see that now we have to group the terms together 2 as a part. Then between those 2 terms we have to take common and our target, our main target is to make the these brackets similar. If we group together like this and if the brackets are not coming same, then we cannot proceed on the next step. So it means we are committing some mistake in grouping. So we have to change the terms in the groups. Then we can take common again. But our main target is to make the brackets similar. Then only we can proceed. So now we are coming to question number 6. Question number 6 is saying 16 a plus b whole square minus 4a minus 4b. So observe it carefully. The first term will be remain same, a plus b whole square. In these two terms you can take 4 as common, so a plus b. Now if you talk about numbers, 4 can be taken as common because 16 and 4, 4 will be common. And a plus b whole square is there. And a plus b power 1 is there. So a plus b can be taken as common. So the remaining will be 4a plus b and minus 1. Why 1 is coming? Because all the term we have taken common. So 4a plus b, after that 4a plus 4b minus 1. So that will be the final answer in this question. So there will be small changes in each question. But if you have proper concept knowledge, conceptual knowledge, then you will not fix at any step. You can proceed very calmly. Yes, now we are coming to the next question, question number 7. In this question also we have to group together first the terms. Question number 7 is saying a to the power 4 minus 2a cube minus 4a plus 8. Again, we have to group together. So these two terms group and these two terms. In first two terms, you can take a cube as common. So the result will be a minus 2 only. In last two terms, you can take 4 as common. So again, a minus 2. So a minus 2 remains same in the bracket. So it will be written like this and a cube minus 4. So this is the final answer. If there will be more possibility to solve the steps, then we can solve further. Otherwise, we have to leave the answer. Question number 8. Question number 8 is saying AB minus 2B plus A square minus 2A. Now, in first two terms, we can take B as common. So A minus 2 in the bracket. In last two terms, we can take A as common. So A minus 2. Again, A minus 2 in the same bracket, similar. So A minus 2 and B plus A. That will be the final answer. So we can see that sometimes most of the questions have the terms in grouping form. But sometimes we have to make also. Question number 9. Because these questions are very small in size. Only the logics will be applied in first step only. Then there will be no problem. In question number 9, it is written AB x square plus 1 plus x a square plus b square. Now observe this question. This question is little different from previous questions. We can see that there is nothing is common in brackets. So what we can do first, we have to multiply. AB x square plus AB and plus a square x plus b square x. Now first AB x square plus a square x, we have to take common, we have to make group. And the other two terms, b square x plus ab, we have to make separately. When we check in these two terms, what terms are common? Ax. Ax can be taken as common between these two terms. So what will be the result? Bx plus a. In these two terms, b is common. So bx plus a again. So you can see that bx plus a here also and here also. So bx plus a in first bracket and ax plus b in the second bracket. That is the answer. So you can check that in the very first step, there is nothing is common in between these two terms. So that is why we have no other option to multiply. So we have multiplied all the terms. So we get four terms now after multiplication. So between those four terms, first and third term together and second and fourth term together, then take common, then the brackets will be same. So this is question number 9. Now we are coming to question number 10. It is saying that a square plus b minus ab minus a. Again, in the first two brackets, nothing is common, but there is common in last two terms. So it means they are not grouped properly. So what we have to take? A square minus a. This will be grouped together. And b minus ab. These will be grouped together. So when you take a common, a minus 1. When you will take b common, then 1 minus a. Now there is a change. a minus 1 in the first bracket and 1 minus a in the second bracket. So what can you do? You have to take minus as common. So again it will become a minus 1. Now question will become a minus 1 minus plus minus b a minus 1. So a minus 1 in the first bracket and a minus b in the second bracket. So along with taking common, you have very good knowledge of sign also. How can you change the signs? Because you can see a minus 1 is coming in the first bracket, but 1 minus a was coming in the second bracket. So we have to change them. So this is the question number 10. Now we are proceeding to the next question. Question number 11 now. And we are going to solve more questions. As more practice you will do of any topic in mathematics, then that topic will be easy for us to understand. Because more practice makes a man perfect. Yes. Question number 11. Question number 11 is saying AX plus BY whole square plus BX minus AY whole square. Now in this question, you can see that nothing is common. Only two brackets are there. So what you can do? You can see there are whole squares. So no other possibility other than squaring. So we have to open the square. Here A plus B whole square. So A square plus B square plus 2AB. In the first bracket only I have applied. In the second bracket, A square plus B square minus 2AB. Because it is A minus B whole square. Now it will become A square X square. It will become B square Y square. It will become 2ABXY. It will become B square X square. It will become A square Y square. It will become minus 2ABXY. So negative and positive term will be cancelled. A square X square and B square X square grouped together. And A square Y square plus B square Y square grouped together. Because X square is constant variable in these and Y square is present in these. So when you take x square, a square plus b square remain in the bracket, and when you will take y square is common, then also a square plus b square will return in the bracket. So a square plus b square in the first bracket and x square plus y square in the second bracket. So this is the final answer. So in this we have to use identities also sometimes. Now question number 12. Question number 12 is saying a square x square plus ax square plus 1 into x plus a. Now we have to multiply because right now we can see 3 terms. And for grouping we have either 4 terms or 6 terms. So it can be written as ax square x square plus ax cube plus x plus a. In first 2 numbers we can take ax square as common. So the result will be a plus x. In the last 2 numbers nothing is common. So when nothing is common you can take 1 as common. So also a plus x. So a plus x in the first bracket, ax square plus